Hello everyone, how are you doing? Lately I've been seeing lots of photos from the German photographer Karl Blasfeld. He lived from 1865 to 1932 and he was originally a sculptor. But these days he's mostly known for his botanical photography. He took pictures of flowers and plants, mainly for drawing and painting education. Today I want to take pictures in a similar style. Not only because I just like the photos, but also because I can shoot my own reference photos to use with drawing. His photos were, of course, taken well before the digital age, but we can still study and learn from his work. I've already collected some plant material, so let's get started. To keep them upright, I use a funnel for the plants. I turn it upside down and slide the stem of the plant into the spout. But of course you can use everything you have at home. Depending on the size of the plant you have chosen, you don't need a macro lens for these photos. A handy tip, if you can't focus close enough to get the full picture of the flower, move your camera further away and use a zoom lens. If you don't want shadow, you can move the plants further from the background. They're mostly straightforward close-ups against a neutral background. For all those photos in this series, I use both a white and black piece of foam board. This way you have the same image, but a completely different mood. The light usually comes from the side, and the subject has a large depth of field and the photos have a lot of contrast. Today I mainly use natural light for the exposure. I've blocked part of the window so that only a little bit of light comes in. This ensures a subtle illumination of one side. To get a little bit of that vintage analog feel to the photo, I use Photoshop textures and Lightroom presets in editing. I link the textures and the presets that I've used in the description of this video. For those who don't have Photoshop or Lightroom, for a similar effect, you can just convert the photo to black and white or sepia, and you don't necessarily have to use textures. For most of the plants, I don't know what the species are. Some I found outside, some were in a bouquet of flowers. But I try to collect plants that have interesting shapes and details to let the photo speak for itself. In most pictures, I go for a composition by placing the plants in the middle of the image, like a portrait. Karl Blasfeld also made good use of composition through the shape of some plants. He positioned them in a way that twigs or leaves let your eyes into a certain point in the photo. Sometimes he manipulated the plants by removing certain branches and leaves that stand in the way of a beautiful composition. I really like the berries on this plant, but the leaves are too much for a minimalistic look, so I took them away. Before I started working on this project, I had pictures in my head with a light background, but now that I also see the result with a black background, I prefer the dark photos. So you see that it's very important to try other things as well. What's your favorite? The light or the dark versions. Karl Blasfeld not only photographed portraits of a single plant, but he also combined several in one photo as well. The poppy heads were the only ones that I had more of. I couldn't put all three in the funnel at the same time, so my husband was kind enough to drill a few holes in a piece of wood that I could put all three in at the same time. It took me some fiddling with the different poppy heads and stem length, but in the end I found a nice composition and these became my favorite images of the entire series. I must say, give the block of wood a color and you immediately have a beautiful decoration in your home, don't you think so? It is not always possible to keep plants upright. I also tried out some things by putting them on the table and shooting them from above. It was difficult to find a nice composition for these curls of a grape from our backyard. attention to people with trypophobia. For the last photos, I wanted to photograph a lotus flower from the front. I used the cap of a soda bottle to be able to put it upright without showing it in the final result. I used my softbox for this. I've positioned the lamp very low on the subject so that the light just caught the ridges of the holes and thus created more depth in the photo due to the slightly lighter edges. That's it for this episode. Subscribe for more art and photography and be sure to let me know which were your favorites in the comments below. Have a nice day, until next time.